You determine the domain and range from the graph of the function. Recall the domain is a set of inputs or x values. The range is a set of outputs or y values. To determine the domain, we analyze the graph from left to right or horizontally. Again, notice there's a hole or break in the graph at x equals 1. 1 is not in the domain. Moving to the rightmost point is this closed point where x equals 4. Because of the closed point, 4 is in the interval. The domain contains all the values from 1 to 4, not including 1, but including 4. Going back to x equals 1, the graph moves left indefinitely. We assume there's an arrow here on the graph on the left. The graph goes down and to the left indefinitely. This is the graph of the domain on the x-axis, which is x less than 1, or x greater than 1, and less than or equal to 4. We're using interval notation. X less than 1 is the open interval from negative infinity to 1, and then we have union for or, the interval from 1 to 4, open on 1 and closed on 4. The parenthesis to the left of 1 indicates 1 is not in the interval. The bracket to the right of 4 indicates 4 is in the interval. To determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically. The highest point on the graph is where we have this open point where y equals 4. Because of the open point, y equals 4 is not in the range. And then from here, the graph goes down indefinitely, and y approaches negative infinity. The range is y less than 4. We're using interval notation. We have the open interval from negative infinity to 4. I hope you found this helpful.